Oh, endless hat hair. I didn't think this through. Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, chemistry PhD, skincare nerd, and newly qualified cosmetic chemist. Yes, that's right. I felt so awkward about people accidentally calling me a cosmetic chemist that I went off and got a diploma. That is how bad I am at confrontation. Today, I'm not quite talking about sunscreen. I'm talking about things you can use instead of sunscreen. I can feel my sunscreen propaganda shield box slipping away right now. Time to stop eating avocado on toast, I guess. As much as we all love sunscreen, sometimes it is a bit of a pain in the
what?
You have to apply it right, you have to apply enough, sometimes they can give you rashes and clogged pores, they rub off, they can feel uncomfortable. So it seems like there has to be a better option, right? Today we're talking about hats and umbrellas. I think most of us have seen this Swiss cheese diagram, which has to do with COVID protection. There are lots of different types of protection, each one has some shortcomings, but if you have enough layers of imperfect protection, then they can add up to give you overall pretty decent protection. And I think this is how we should think about sun protection as well. Sunscreen is one layer, it's imperfect, it should be used in conjunction with other things. In Australia, we have the slogan, slip, slop, slap, seek, slide. Slip on a shirt, slop on some sunscreen, slap on a hat, seek shade, and slide on some sunglasses. But how well does each one work? Why do we still get burnt in the shade? Can we wear a hat instead of wearing sunscreen? Let's start by talking about where UV comes from. It obviously comes from the sun, but there are two different types of UV exposure, which you might remember from my video about whether or not you need to wear sunscreen indoors. We have direct UV exposure. This is where the sun is falling on your skin. When you're in the sun, you have direct exposure. When you're in the shade, you have indirect exposure. Then there's indirect or diffuse UV exposure. This is where the sun's UV bounces off something else onto you. Usually that something else is air molecules high up in the sky, but sometimes it's also the ground or other objects around you. This bouncing around also happens with visible light, which is why you can still see things when they're in the shade. Shorter wavelengths of light get diffused more, so there's more diffuse UV around than visible light, and more diffuse UVB than UVA. If you're standing in the middle of an empty field, then out of all the UV coming in towards you, about 60% of the UV you're getting is diffuse, and 40% is direct. These percentages are very rough and they change with lots of different factors like how high the sun is in the sky, where you are in the world, what time of year it is, what wavelength of light you're talking about. But the key thing is the UV shining directly on you is actually less than half of your total UV. Working out how much direct UV you're getting is pretty straightforward. If the sun is shining on you, then you're getting that direct 40%. Working out diffuse UV is trickier. We need to work out how much stuff is bouncing UV on us. If you're outside, the main thing bouncing UV on you is probably the sky. We can use something called sky view to work out how much UV we're getting. So if you're standing outside in the middle of a field, you can imagine that you're surrounded by a dome of blue sky. That is 100% exposure to diffuse UV, and the amount of diffuse UV you're getting is proportional to the amount of sky that you can see. If there's stuff between you and the sky, then you have lower sky view and lower diffuse UV. If half of the sky is blocked out, then you're getting about half the diffuse UV. So if you're standing right next to a building and you're standing in the sun, then you are getting that direct 40% UV plus half of that 60% diffuse UV. That gives you a total of 70% of the UV that you would get compared to standing in the middle of a field. If you're not in the sun, but half of the sky is blocked, so you're standing next to a barn, but the sun's moved and now you're in the shadow, that means you're not getting the direct UV anymore. You're not getting that 40%. But you are still getting half of that 60%, you're getting 30% of the UV you would be getting if there was nothing else in the field. Now, in some situations, the ground can also reflect quite a lot of UV. Most surfaces absorb most of the UV that comes in, so this is like grass, dirt, asphalt. Apparently Americans call this bitumen. But there are some surfaces that do reflect more, so apparently in some countries there's this thing called snow, and that can reflect up to 90%. If you're standing in this so-called snow, the snow can actually bounce up more UV than the sun and the sky combined. Sand can be 10 to 40% depending on the type of sand, concrete is around 10%. So depending on the UV index, even if you're standing in the shade, all of this bouncy UV can still add up. So that's why you can still get burnt in the shade. If you're standing and you're facing the sky or ground that can bounce up UV, you can still get a lot of UV, and remember, UVB wavelengths get scattered more. When you're in the shade, you usually feel quite cool because visible light and infrared, which is 90% of the energy coming from the sun, That's the stuff that heats you up and it's getting blocked, but that UVB can still bounce around and get onto you. If you face away from the sun, then the UV bouncing onto your face is going to be cut down by a lot, even though you feel around the same temperature wise. So, hats and umbrellas, basically portable shade. How much protection are we getting? Let's start with hats. Hats are usually made with thick material that will block out almost all the direct UV. So an Akubra hat, which looks like this, blocks out everything but 1/2000th of the UV. So this leaves 0.05% getting through. But of course, if you have a hat made out of thinner fabric, then the UV is going to increase. You might remember my video about UPF clothing, the same points apply here. So if you're looking for a hat that blocks out more UV, you're looking for a synthetic fabric with really tight knit. Basically, you want really small holes and as few holes as possible. If you have a few layers, then that helps. Basically, the less breathable it is, the better it is. Intense colors are also better because fabric dyes can absorb UV. The bigger the hat, the more sky it's going to block out, and if the brim turns down, it's going to be a bit more protective than if the brim turns up because you can see more sky off the side. So for example, this hat is probably going to give better protection than this hat, even though they are around the same size. But they do give you hat hair. This is a terrible hat for sun protection. I don't know why I bought it. I do because I was pressured to by space nerds. If you're wearing a cap like this, you can imagine a little man standing on your face. He's going to still get a lot of sky view. It'll be blocked over here, but you're still getting all of this, plus you're getting some direct UV every once in a while as well shining on your face. But a little man standing here in the middle of your head is going to get a lot less sky view. He can't see all of the sky up here. But even with a broader brimmed hat, there can still be a really big difference. So a little man standing here near your forehead is going to get a lot of sky view blocked out by this bit, like that. Hats don't work with fringes. So in general, the forehead and the nose get the least sun exposure, the cheeks and the chin get the most because they're further away from the brim. They're not getting their view blocked out by this brim as much as if they were up here. And for parts of your face that are angled upwards, the hat is going to block more. A little dude lying on your nose is going to get more stuff blocked out by a hat than someone lying on your face and looking sideways. But of course, there's also the ground. A hat isn't going to protect you against UV bouncing off the ground, which could be a significant problem if you're somewhere like in the snow. One study estimated that with this Akubra, a farm worker in Queensland would drop down their yearly exposure of UV down to 1/7 for their forehead, 1/3 for their nose, but by less than a half for their cheek. Their overall face protection factor was 2-6, but in some parts of their face, it could be up to 100. Now with umbrellas, we can think of these as like hats, but further away from your head. The further away it is, the bigger it has to be to block out the same amount of sky. If the umbrella doubles in distance from your nose, so maybe to here, then the radius has to double to give the same amount of protection. One big difference between hats and umbrellas is that umbrellas tend to be made out of thinner material, so usually more direct UV can get through. And this can be really variable. In studies, it's been found that regular rain umbrellas can let through as much as 23% of the UV, or as little as 0.1%. Unsurprisingly, given what we know about fabrics from UPF clothing, black umbrellas work the best, and also umbrellas that have a UPF rating. This umbrella from Uniqlo claims to be UPF 40, which means it lets through 2.5% of UV. I'm not sure I believe the UPF rating for this umbrella, but it's supposedly bigger than 50 plus, so it should be letting in less than 2%. Another difference with umbrellas is you're usually off to the side with an umbrella, so one side of your face can get a lot more UV, and depending on where your umbrella is and how wide it is, you could actually be getting more UV exposure with your umbrella than with a hat. But on the bright side, you don't get hat hair. Annoyingly for our purposes, most studies have been done on beach umbrellas, which are stuck in the ground and much bigger. Overall, in studies with beach umbrellas, you can get a protection factor of between 3 and 17 depending on the size of the umbrella, where you are under the umbrella, the thickness of the umbrella, where the sun is, and so on. Another study estimated that if you're sitting in the shade under an umbrella in the middle of summer and you're not wearing any other protection, as illustrated by these helpful but slightly creepy diagrams, you can still get burned in 2 hours. So here are the takeaways. Hats and umbrellas are great for giving UV protection that you don't need to reapply and won't wear off quickly. They also protect areas that you might not easily be able to cover with sunscreen or clothing, like your scalp or like the edge of your eyelids, although there are sunglasses for that, that will be a different video. They're particularly good for protecting against direct UV, but it's that 60% diffuse UV that gets you. These umbrellas and hats only really protect the circle of sky right above your head. There's all of the edge where stuff can bounce in. To protect against diffuse UV, you're going to need sideways protection like a wall or trees to get between you and the sky. Or you can go for something that's closer to your skin like sunscreens and clothing. If you're in a high sun exposure situation, remember the Swiss cheese layers. Don't just rely on one type of protection, use multiple types. High sun exposure includes going to the beach and exercising in the sun. In lower UV exposure situations, like if you're only going outside for a few minutes or if it's in winter, unless you're in one of those places that gets this snow thing, then you're going to need less layers of Swiss cheese. So I hope this video was useful. You might also like my videos about whether or not you need to wear sunscreen indoors, whether or not you need to reapply sunscreen, how to reapply sunscreen, my video on sun protective clothing, and maybe just my sunscreen videos in general. Like, subscribe, notification bell, check out my blog, check me out on Instagram, and I will see you next time for more nerdery.